everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about how to juggle multiple works in progress. This is something that I am doing currently. For those of you who don't know, I have work in progress number one, which is Essence. I have work in progress number two, which is Annie. And then I guess work in progress number three is book two of Essence. So I'm one of those writers that's working on multiple projects. This is something not every writer will want to do or even can do. Those of you who are a little bit crazy like me, I have some tips for you on how to manage juggling multiple works in progress. The reason you may be, you know, wanting to write multiple works in progress, because if you're like me, you'll be working on one and then this other idea will go, hey, just like barges in and takes over your mind away from your other project. And you get really excited about it, more excited than the one you're currently working on, and then you want to work on this one. That happens. You should always write down the new idea. But the kind of more important part of this is then you want to consider, should you pursue this new idea or should you continue working on the one you were working on? For me, I used to ignore. I'd write the ideas down and just ignore it. But I found that because I was ignoring it, I wanted to work on it, and then what I was producing on the one I was forcing myself to work on, I was being really sloppy with it. So I wanted to finish it fast so I could work on the new project kind of thing. And I just found it never really worked, so I found a system where I work at different projects kind of at the same time. I had to learn to accept that my progress was going to be slowed. Because I was working, it was divided on two different projects. So if I thought I was going to finish the draft in 3 months, well, no, I'm probably going to take more like 5 months because I'm also working on another project. So if you're, you know, working on multiple projects, you really have to accept that it's going to be an even slower process than working on one. Another thing I learned was that it's easier to work on multiple projects when they're kind of at different stages. I don't think I would actually be able to draft two different novels at the same time, but I can draft one novel while editing or revising another. Since has been kind of in the editing phase for the last year. Annie, I was drafting it last year. Now Annie's kind of more in the revision phase, and now then my new drafting project is book two for Essence. It's really helpful when some days I want to write new things, so I do that while I'm drafting. And some days I get really frustrated with the drafting process because it's not perfect, which is my biggest issue with the drafting process. And so then I just want to work on something I can fix, like editing. Go with how you feel. Force yourself to work on a certain project because you feel you need to be working on that project. Work on the one that you really want to work on for that day or week. I feel like working on Essence one day, I will work at Essence. On Essence, if I feel like working on the book two, or well, currently right now Annie is on break, but if I wanted to work on one of those, then I would go and do that. I've learned, like I said at the beginning, when I'm ignoring my kind of desire, quality of work is kind of low. So I've learned to just go with what I want to do that night. Content and working on multiple works in progress. I've heard that some writers have concerns about getting kind of confused between their different projects or just not being able to keep them both straight. And I've actually haven't ever run into that problem myself. I have a very kind of, when it comes to my writing, very organized. I know what happens in one story, what happens in the other, and I know my characters between one and the other. So I never have actually been confused, or just I've never really run into that issue. If you're worried about that, it really helps having your outlines down and having your character sketches down so that you can have, well, this is one group of characters, this is a story, this is the world, and then having another. It also helps when you're working on multiple projects, like if they're different genres, that on a fantasy for one project and a contemporary or science fiction, having separate genres can really help keep your two stories straight. Like for me, well, they're both fantasy, but Annie's story is set half the time in contemporary Canada, like today, And then she travels to a different world. And Essence is like its own separate world, like kind of Middle Earth, Lord of the Rings. Then it also helps for me, Annie's written in first person and Essence is written in third person, and also switches between different perspectives, whereas Annie is focused on Annie. And so that's also kind of helped me kind of separate the two stories and not get confused by them. So I'm not necessarily saying because you're working on one work in progress, the other one has to be written in a different tense or a different genre, but doing things that kind of make them different really, really helps. Summarize my rambling in this video. Now, if you want to work on multiple projects, the things you need to keep in mind is accept that your progress is going to be slow. It's easier if your works in progresses are at different stages in the process. 3, go when you want to work on a certain one, work on that. Don't force yourself to work on the other because you think you need to be doing the other. Go with your gut and work on the project you want to work on for that day or writing period. And then as for content and getting confused, it helps if your projects are in different genres or different tenses. And also, again, make sure that you have your outlines and your character sketches. If you found this video helpful in any ways, please like it and share it with the world. You can also subscribe to my channel. I post advice videos on Sundays. And I also post day in the life vlogs kind of whenever I feel like it. If you want to connect with me, I'm on social media. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.